this is connected up. This is an internet device. There's a module controlling it, and Dwayne has control here from the center. Let's say he's left the house, and someone forgot to turn off the lights in the house. From here, he can see, right now the lights are off, right? So let's say he's coming home, and he wants to turn all the lights on, open the garage door, set the temperature. With one press, he's able to do all that. So go ahead and lights are turned on now. So he's controlling that. Listen, just to do it again, go ahead and turn it off, Dwayne. So he sends a command. Oh, it didn't highlight. Yeah. Sends a command over to the device. Device goes off. Anyway, your garage door, your thermostat, all this is going to be controlled, and you'll have control of it, from your car, so that you set the house up for you. When you get there, everything's ready. Up next is the diagnostics. Here, with electric vehicle, you want to get the status of the battery, status of the fuel. And what Dwayne has right now is all the information that he needs for this vehicle. Its status, its range. Since this has both the battery and gas, you have a range of about 360 miles. And this gives you the full status, as well as the charging, when it is going to be scheduled to start charging, or when do you want it to finish charging, so that you can program it to just charge at night when the rates are low, but make sure that it's ready at 5:33 in the morning when you're ready to go. It'll be fully charged. Next is a station locator. If you're off in a city you're not familiar with, and you have your vehicle and you want to find a charging station, with this it pulls up a map of the area, gives you all of the fuel stations that are out there, as well as charging stations. When you go to fill up your car, you go in, 2 or 3 minutes, you're fully fueled, you're off and you're gone. With charging, it's going to take a little bit longer than that. So when you get to when you find a station, you want to make sure it's available for you when you get there. So you hear, he can pick a station, reserve it. So when he gets there, not only did he find the charging station, but it's ready for him to start charging. It's reserved for him. Now we're going to move to the back of the vehicle to show you some of the concepts of streaming 4G LTE to the back seat. And the best one is, I think, movies, right? You can't have movies in the vehicle until you have a pretty wide bandwidth connection. 4G LTE gives you that wide band connection. What Dwayne has done is he's launched an application that gives him access to all of the streaming services that he subscribes to, as well as any content that he has in his home, movies and things that he may have bought that he wants to stream to the car. So here, he's brought up all of the different applications. He's going to pick a movie, and with 4G LTE, he is streaming that movie from a server in Massachusetts, over here to this car. And this is just an example of one video streaming, but with 4G LTE, you can have two videos going concurrently and still have plenty of bandwidth for the rest of the vehicle to communicate, for the infotainment system to communicate. Also, when you launch a video from the back, Dwayne has all the control from the front. So if you have a small kid in a car seat who can't reach it, Dwayne can start the movie, as well as change the volume, pause, fast forward, rewind, or just stop the movie. So here he can stop the movie. Now no one has to control it. And that's the difference between just bringing tablets into the car and integrating tablets into the car. So all of these have been integrated with the work that we've done in this research vehicle to really show 4G and the interaction between the different zones. YouTube is another video streaming service that's very popular. With here, Dwayne's able to launch YouTube. If you have teenagers, ask any teenager or YouTube, they got to have access to what's going on YouTube. So from here, and with 4G LTE, you can stream whatever the viral video of the day is right to the back seat, no problem. Another really interesting. I'll get it, Dwayne. I think one of the most interesting ones, though, is Skype video. Everyone's familiar with Skyping and Skype video, but what about Skyping in your car, video, and maybe Skyping car to car? Well, we put this together. In fact, we put two cars together. We have the car here in the Verizon booth, as well as we have a car in the OnStar booth. And they're both similar type of setups where we have a car and we have a Skype session and a camera on there. They've been watching us and doing Skypes and watching us pretty much all day give our demos. Why don't we give them a Skype call and see what they're doing over there at their booth? So, just like any Skype, you make a call, they send it over, they see the call come through, and in a second here we're going to see, there they are over at the North Hall in a vehicle just like this, and we'll see them, we'll be Skyping with them here in a little bit, and they'll see us, you'll see it pop up, but anyways, these are some of, I think this is just the surface, so just scratching the surface of some of the capabilities that you'll have in vehicles with 4G LTE in the future, and I hope you enjoy the demo. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Yep.